What I have here is the Estes ready to fly, because I like instant satisfaction. Fly them out of rocket, and this is the Patriarch edition. This is actually based on the Patriarch ballistic missile, and it's 18 inches tall. It should fly up to about 600 feet in the air, depending on the engine. And it's all ready to go. The only thing you have to do is insert the parachute into the nose cone, and also add the recovery wadding, which I'll show you how to do. Let's take this bad boy apart. Now, as you can see, the fins are clear to give it the effect of an actual ballistic missile going up. Ballistic missiles, I guess, do not have the fins like this. The fins, of course, give the rocket stability during flight. Okay, as you can see, I took the nose cone out of the body of the rocket, and you can see that the nose cone is attached to the body of the rocket with a rubber band. And so now what you want to do is go ahead and attach the recovery parachute to the rubber band. Easily done. Go ahead and take the strings that are attached to the parachute and hold them together like that. Leave one finger. Pull the tip of the parachute back. Now go ahead and put the strings of the parachute under the rubber band and slip the parachute through the strings, and that's all there is to it. Pull it until it's taut and tied. Now, one note about the nomenclature for these engines. The B-4-4 is a classification of the engines. B, the letter, will give you the total impulse. B engines have an impulse of about 2.5 to 5 newton seconds. A, about half that. C, about double the B's. And D's, about double the C's, etc. The first number is the average thrust. The last number indicates the time in seconds between the end of the thrust period and the ejection charge to release your parachute. And a lot more information is given on the Estes site. And I believe that's estesrockets.com. Next, you will want to prepare your parachute for deployment once the flight has completed. So in order to accomplish that, you will first have to put in 3 to 4 pieces of the recovery wadding. Now, this is a recovery wadding. It's a tissue, but it's specially treated such that it will not be flammable. Don't use rubber tissue paper. Otherwise, you might start a major fire. So you take the recovery wadding, just loosely crumple it, and you put it into the body of your rocket. There's one piece. Put in 2 more pieces. Very loose. Now, next, you'll want to prepare your parachute for deployment. And the way to do that is, again, hold the parachute by the end, by the tip. Flip it over once, like that. And pull on the sides loosely. And roll the string around the parachute. And then place the parachute into the body, tip first. Again, you have detailed instructions that come with your rockets. Now, as for the engines, I am not going to put the engine in yet. I'm going to wait until I'm ready to launch. However, at the base of your rocket, you just simply unscrew the base and you can insert your engine into the base here. Very simple, but a lot of fun.